Hello, so today I will be showing you how to bulk fulfill an order with the Matrixify app. For example's sake, I will be showing you only how to fulfill one order with the app. However, once you get the method down and you understand it, the exact same method that I'm about to show you will work for 10, 100, 1,000 orders in bulk. But this is generally just to show you the process that you would need to fulfill an order with the Matrixify app. So here you can see I have an example order that we will be fulfilling. And so that I fulfill only this order, I am going to copy the ID so then I can export it. But generally, if you're fulfilling orders in bulk, then you would not need to use filters, or you can use filters to export only specific orders. That's completely up to you. But in this example, I will only be exporting this one order as an example. So the first thing we would need to do is go to the Matrixify app. And here you will see you can export, you can import. In this case, we're going to want to export the order that we would like to fulfill. So here, as you can see, I already have the order sheet selected, but if on your page, for example, you see the orders aren't selected, then you'd go to the Select Sheets dropdown and select Orders from this dropdown. Then you'd want to click this dropdown, and in this dropdown, you'd select basic columns, line type, and fulfillment. In theory, you can leave it as is now and export all 55 of the basic columns, 3 columns from line type, and 10 columns from fulfillment. This won't hinder anything, it won't break anything. However, to make the exported file a lot easier to understand, we do recommend to export only the minimum columns necessary to fulfill an order. And here's how you can do so. So you'd press the basic columns dropdown, and all you need to select is ID, name, and command. ID and name will identify the order, and command will tell the app what to do with the order. The rest of these columns are definitely not needed to fulfill an order. Then from line type, you'd select row, top row, line type. Line type will tell the app the row of the order which we'd be working with, which in this case will be fulfillment line. So we definitely need this in the file. Row number and top row are basically columns added by us to better help navigate the exported file. You can keep them in the file, in the export, you can omit them from the export, that's completely up to you, but they definitely do make the exported file a lot easier to navigate if you do keep them. And then we have fulfillment. For fulfillment, you can uncheck created at and updated at. The reason for this is because the values for these columns cannot be imported, which means there's not really any point in exporting them since you can't import them back anyway. So you can also omit those from the exported file. As I would only like to export that one order, I am going to press filter, select filter and ID, as I will be exporting by the order ID, and then I will press add. Now you can use any filter you would like to filter out certain orders. We do offer quite a few filters when it comes to exporting orders. It's completely up to you. You can also mix and match filters. You can add different ones together, but in this case, I will only be using the ID filter. So once everything is set up and you've selected which format you'd like to export in this case, I'll be exporting in the Excel format. If you are exporting a large amount of data, a very large amount of data, we do recommend to export in the CSV format. However, if you are not exporting millions and millions of rows, then Excel will work perfectly fine as well. But it is definitely up to you which you feel more comfortable with using. But in this case, yes, I will be using the Excel format. So once everything is set up, you don't need to change any options. Once everything looks good, then press export. And once the export has finished, you would then need to press download exported file. So my exported file has downloaded, and here we can see my order. Now, you basically want to change the command column from new to update. In the line type column, you'd want to add the value fulfillment line. And now we get to the fulfillment columns. Now, as we would be creating a new fulfillment for the order, we do not need to add a fulfillment ID value. So you can leave that empty because the fulfillment will not yet have an ID since a fulfillment has not yet been created and Shopify itself sets and generates the fulfillment IDs once fulfillment is created. But our order does not yet have one as it has not yet been filled. So you do not need to fill this value. Fulfillment status. To fulfill an order, the fulfillment status column value should be success. So we will add that value here. Now, if you have a tracking company, you'd add the tracking company here. You'd add a fulfillment location here. The fulfillment location would need to be where the product in the order is actually stocked in your store for the fulfillment to be properly processed. So that would be the value you'd put here. Shipment status, if you'd want the order to be delivered, for example, in this column, you'd put the value delivered. You can also add a tracking number, for example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, or whatever example you would like to add here. Not example, but tracking number, sorry. And then you can add a tracking URL. And if you would like to notify your customer of this fulfillment, you'd set fulfillment send receipt to true, which would then notify the customer of this fulfillment. As you can see, these columns are not obligatory to fill. The only column that would definitely be obligatory to fill to fulfill an order would be the fulfillment status column to success. Every other column would be optional. In a sense, apart from fulfillment location, this would really need to be where your product is actually stocked in store. This is only for orders though that are linked to an actual product in store. If your order has a custom line item, then you can also leave this empty because the product obviously is not stocked anywhere as it is a custom line item. But generally, this is how your file should look before you import. So once everything looks good, everything looks as it should, save your file. I'm going to save this as fulfillment example test, the Matrixify app, press import, and then find the file that you have just created, which here would be fulfillment example test. Wait till the file analyzes, make sure that the file has been recognized as orders and that the columns have been recognized. It's okay that row number and top row have not been recognized as these columns cannot be imported, they can only be exported. And that's completely okay if they're export only. The rest should be recognized. And if everything looks good, it should, press import. And as you can see, everything's updated correctly. Everything looks good. And then if we look at the order in Shopify admin, you'll then see that it has been fulfilled. And you can see that here is my tracking number that I added. So yes, that would be the general idea of how to fulfill an order.